Hello, welcome back. So I just did a lot of busy work, and you know, the busy work doesn't really pay off, but as you can see, we did the quest as well. We have 1000 crowns. Yeah, we did most of the stuff. My reputation is currently is very low because, you know, I did a little bit of theft and that little trick with... Shut up. And the little trick with the dungeon without the boss. So I guess you could say I'm kind of very advanced in the game, especially considering I've been playing only for about 5 or 6 hours, or I don't know, something like that. But in total I have about 190 hours into the game. Imagine that, 190 hours. Now this build is becoming very, very serious. I got a bit lucky with the counter chance, I don't know why. So we're going to Brynn, and let's visit Brynn. My stats are a bit wild because I just did the dungeon. Here is your 1000, let's go to Brynn. I'll also try to go in the middle of the night so I can arrive in the middle of the day. I like the little animation. Go and explore the city, recover your strength, a suitable place for the horses. Docks in the close harbor. Oh, we got a little thirsty. Yeah, the street cleaners can pick that up. Oh, there's Poppy over here. So let's explore Brynn in its full glory. I mean, I didn't want to explore it when it first came out because I was expecting also a content patch. Okay, so they have Barberries, which gives us energy restoration, which is actually bad. Don't use energy restoration because you sleep less, which is a big minus. So this is Osbrook, the mill, the brewery. I still hope they'll make more stuff with the brewery. The abandoned road car basically had nothing for me. Manshire is over there. And this is Brynn. Brynn outskirts, to be more precise. Yeah, I don't think there is anything out here. So let's just explore and relax a little bit. I had to work a lot of hours to get over here. And also, we'll see what we can steal, because that's part of the game. By the way, if you steal stuff and they see you, actually, Varen will attack you. So if you, for example, steal something from this over here, Varen will attack you and he's very, very strong. He'll beat you very easy. Stable master, no rumors. So I still don't like the system where they can see you. Look at this. See? They can see you from every angle, so I think they should change that a little bit, or I don't know, make it a little more fair. The only way you can steal from people is if you go during the night in their house. Okay, so let's do that again. I just wanted to prove a point, and yeah, like I said, you can steal from the elder in Manshire. Very easy, very, very discreetly, very efficiently. Like I said, I could show you Varen's kind of combat power. Looks like an old man, but he's not an old man. Here is your 1000, let's go. I think he'll be very dangerous. Inspect, look at this. Very dangerous, human, get damage, strat health, 100 effects. On all mercenary, you counter also your old, but hardly your closest acquaintance. That's the damage he deals to us. I think you can try to kill him later. Or maybe you want to come here, I don't know, maybe there's an easter egg if you kill him. I'm curious what he drops, maybe someone can try that, I will not try that. Because let's just say it's just very time consuming to do it. I think you can only do it during this little encounter. I don't know, I just thought it was interesting to show you that. So, 15... I guess he has about what? Let's just say he has about 150 HP. You can clearly kill him. Maybe someone can write in the comment what you get for killing him. It seems like the game doesn't end anyway. It might be a fun little thing to do. Okay, now let's properly explore this place. As you can see, you're not allowed to go inside the places. Horse, beast. Wildlife, I don't think they're wild. Well, I guess you can steal a bit of rope and some straw. So what is here? Only the stables? Okay, that's off limits. Yeah, not much to do over here. I guess if you arrive during the night, maybe they'll go to sleep and you can steal the stuff from inside. But anyway, let's get moving. Sorry, I wasted so much time showing you that. City of Gold, achievement unlocked. So this was the City of Gold they called in the upcoming, in the, what is the roadmap, yeah. It was called the City of Gold in the roadmap. Oh, it's huge, it actually has more sectors than I thought. Let's just go inside. I'm a mercenary. Of course, just barely and very slowly. Okay, they give you a leaflet. I'm almost afraid to read it. All is open for hardworking craftsmen, honest merchants, and those who wish to fight for our cause. Square and the docks. Guild quarter. Vanguard is recruiting in the old tower. It's a very crumpled old note. Oh no, that's stealing. I guess you can enter into all of the houses. Maybe you can, we can go berserk at some point and kill everyone over here. Huh, very interesting. Not much to steal, I guess. Okay, let's do kind of like this little roundabout. I don't think we'll do any missions or do any combat. Inspect the chicken. Chickens are picky. Warm coop and hand full of grain. Yeah. Apparently there is a chest in here, or I don't know, it's a bug or something. Maybe the developers, I don't know, made a little mistake where it's some kind of an Easter egg, or I don't know. Why do I have the feeling that everything can be an Easter egg in this game? Okay, he has nothing. I guess he can repair all boots, he's a nice guy. They all say the same thing. Oh, nice, the water is also animated. Oh, there are a lot of guards. Okay, let's drink some water because we're very thirsty. Oh, this looks like a place where they sell weapons. Okay, who's the merchant then? This might be the merchant. The sack with all of the thief. Their worship is already supplied with the best goods, don't bring him rubbish. It's kind of weird to hear because everyone wants to barter, everyone wants something, but no, not these guys. It looks like Mr. Fancy Pants over here, everyone in the guild, doesn't want to barter with us. Oh, nice. There is a lot of stuff to see. Sadly, I think it's a little repetitive. And you don't have any voice lines. Oh, they are the beach. You can get a stick and play with our dog. I was expecting him to sell some food, but nope. Those are very nice animations, top quality. Okay, this is a fun little city. Hey, bring your bags. This is the perfect place for a vacation. You don't sell anything? Oh, what? The blacksmith guild was disbanded. Or craftsman orchid. Oh, in the common goal, that's why. Gold candelabrum ornate inkpot. A bottom elven ice wine. Access to some, oh, okay, so this will be hard. So I guess you have to come here very, very early so you know what to take. Golden candelabrum, ornate inkpot, and elven ice wine. Oh, that will be very hard to find. I guess that means I'll have to play for even more before I can actually do stuff over here. That looks like it's dangerous to enter. Let's not do that. It looks like this place has a problem getting you supplied. At least it sells me a ladder. It's more than the other people will sell me, okay. This is a weird mechanic, so I guess you cannot do anything over here when you come over here. So you don't really have access to the Golden City. It's more like super limited access. Yeah. In case the developers lied a little bit, since you need to play the game a lot more to access stuff. Oh, this is the inn. Why is it called the Freepots? Grand Ball? Very interesting, I don't care. What is this? Herb roasted fish spoils in one day. So hunger, morale, oh morale, 10%. Also fatigue and immunity, oh that's very good. But it's so expensive. Vegetable ragu, okay, so you basically get a lot more morale by eating this stuff. Potatoes with mushrooms, sounds good. Fish soup. Morale, huh. I'll have the old plain lentil soup, please. Ah, looks like they have the same things more or less. I guess this is my room. Complete with the empty chest. Oh, we can go up. No, I don't think I want to buy or sell anything or do anything creepy. Where was I supposed to meet Veren? Wait, where is the close harbor? Okay, I guess we need to go into the other side of the city. Yeah, this really feels like a big city, I like it. Well, I don't think I enjoyed the moving around and the quest just to access the shops. I mean, the shops should be kind of opened at least to some degree to you. And they don't even have rumors, okay, this is boring. I guess the only thing you can do mainly in the town is go on a rampage and kill everyone. Brothel. Ah, folks, okay, let's visit. Oh no. No, no. I guess they only open during the night or something. Oh, they have the local drunkard. Okay, he's busy. Okay, let's find that guy and speak with him. Yeah, this is a little boring. As you can see, the movement speed really creates a problem. Let me guess, you don't sell anything. Oh, you he sells stuff. Finally, we find a merchant. So I guess this is the general merchant. Sapphire ring. That's pretty expensive. Exquisite gold ring. Worth it. I guess the prices are acceptable over here as well. So we have a flanked maze. Crit chance 50% days. I guess you can buy stuff from this place as well. Even though it's so expensive, it's better than what they have in Manshare. So I think this is kind of like 50% more expensive than it should be, but it's quite good. You can come over here, buy one of these, and basically you'll be set for most of the game. Okay, that's worth noting. I guess I got very lucky. I should have had more money with me, because I would have bought this one in an instant. Maybe even this one, I don't know. Maybe. Emporium of Curious Goods. I guess you cannot go inside. So I guess you can buy healing potions from this place in the beginning. Oh, that's pretty good. 15 costing and 5 poison damage. Oh, that's super nice as well. What about the belt? Mystic belt. Huh, really good for mystics apparently. Trawler eye, just barter fodder. Very nice, we can buy the health potions directly from here. Okay, I kind of see the point of the city. So this is kind of like a tier 3 city. Osbrook is tier 1, Manshire is tier 2, this is tier 3. Oh, there he is. Bumble, Granata can work there just fine. Yeah, let's do the quest, because I think this one unlocks something for us, a caravan or something. Oh no, this is dangerous. I guess you might lose him in the crowd. Let's mention to keep up. He lives in a hovel? There's a mansion in the old towers, in the meddling neighbors, and how they wouldn't keep his nose out of his affair. He used the money to buy this shack. What did he do with the rest of the money? Buy a castle in another land? To take the boards off the windows. Yeah, those are nice. They don't let anyone see what's inside. It's Varen. Harder. Huh, the door is unlocked. Yeah, curious, right? The door is unlocked. Okay, this looks like it's something has gone bad. Where's Guinier? Come on, help him with that. But first of all, let's see what we can steal. So he has been gone for a while. Empty bottles are not worth a lot. So page 1. To find the item he was sent to retrieve. It's him fighting the item. Yes, okay, so we have to find the item we are sent to retrieve, which was the stone shard. He has been gone for a while. It's 1 out of 4, so where is the rest of the pages? Yeah, I'm trying to arrange this a little bit. Oh, okay. Deal with Varen. I had a bad, yeah, I have a bad feeling about this. The house had been picked clean. Forget about it, but there's not even a bench to sleep on. A hidden stash or passageway somewhere, okay? I guess we have to use our mouse button. Oh, okay. The old book in the library case. Yeah, I guess he chose it because it had a secret hiding place in the basement. Okay, let's study up a little bit. We cannot let this go like this. It's pretty creepy. The stench, and no sign of Gwindel either. Okay, I guess we'll find more journal pages. Was the price I paid too high? Perhaps was there another way? I don't think so. Everything unfolds according to destiny. Therefore, I am to endure every hardship thrown at me without flinching, and I must never forget that the reward awaiting us in the end will far away its price and misery. What? This is already sounding very suspicious. Okay, so this is where he had his bed. So there was a body over there as well. Strong unpleasant smell. Oh, a travel pot, I can actually sell this. Ah, there we are with the valuables. I guess I should have eaten some of this stuff. Let's leave the rope there. Morion, that's actually pretty expensive. Yeah, let's put the things over there. I never use them anyway. Gwynel's Elixir. Also, this is where it comes from. This is actually one of the best things in the game. This elixir, the bluish elixir, is great. Possibly, man, there must be at least some records in the academy's library after all, if not there were. The cathedral, the university, some of the abbeys that are still intact. Each new day is harder than the last. I'm running out of supplies and I don't remember the last time I had a good night's sleep. I feel the sight of my reflection. If nothing changes, I have a few months at best. So he was dying and he created the elixir. That's very interesting. Is Gwynel sick or something? Slaving over an alchemy table day and night, there's no way around it. What do you make of all of this? Trash laboratory is intact. We aren't the only ones to question Gwynel. But I guess the ones who did that didn't know how to read, because if they had known how to read, they would have found the secret basement. Somewhere in the city, man, the journal mentioned. Stone shards. Prior to that, Chaisa Kustabi would spend days scouring the libraries of both universities and the cathedrals. The monks had the stone shard in their possession for many years. I'm sure at least they made at least some notes on it. Oh yeah. So here's at the Abbey. Or set a temporary camp outside the city walls, you'll be able to find me there. Well, I guess I'm carrying too many items. Let's start eating them. I think we can complete the quest. And that's kind of it for the main quest for now. Okay, let's go outside. Maybe we'll, I don't know, see something else or do something else. Oh, it's over there. Okay. I distinctly remember that we can do something over there, but I'm not sure what. Okay, let's continue exploring the city. Oh, the fires are burning now. I don't want to take my chances, I don't want to be killed over some eggs. Do you have any rumors for me, or are you just that type of person? No rumors for me, not yet. Well, it's nice that they give you some loot, but still, eh, it's a little meh. Fat Jens grocery store. Okay, so I guess that's the whole city. Let's see if we can find the exit. Watch Tower Tavern. How many taverns do they need? Okay, let's watch it. Let's see how it looks inside and then we'll go. Looks very nice. Oh. Hmm, 36. Well, I guess we can sell these items here. Except for that one. Yeah, well, I guess we are slowly recovering our sanity. Sorry, I'll not go upstairs, but I want to go to the camp and finish the dialogue and then, I don't know, end the video. Well, these guys look much heavily armored than the rest. Oh, this is the way out. Perfect. Also, I had some rumors that put the campsite over there. So, Mainshire is very close to Bryn, and Bryn is basically at the edge of the sea or ocean, or who knows. I don't think anything will attack me. That would be hilarious. Oh, we're already a pig. I think gooseberries are the better ones, yeah. Health restoration. So I don't get it. Is the camp on this tile or one tile above me? I think it's one tile above me. Okay, let's slowly go over there and see. I guess Bryn is a nice town with many opportunities, like they said. Just need to have 4,000... 5,000 gold when you come over here and you can buy a great armor or a great weapon. That mace was not particularly nice. Okay, where is the campsite? Did he camouflage it or what? But if you go up there, it's... Yeah, it should be on this tile. Oh, there it is. So I guess it's not a big camp. Oh, it's actually pretty big. I mean, it's the wagon, a few horses and sleeping places and other stuff. Storage. What is the storage? Oh, we actually have a big storage. Oh, very interesting. I guess we can also... No, no, we keep this with us. I think I'll use this during the troll boss battle. I hope that's water. Ah, that's cool, clean water. Okay, so we have a bit of food, we have infinite water. Let's sleep for 1 hour and then we'll talk to this guy. I'm still busy with the caravan, so it will have to be a while before we can set up. If you need a place to store your things, feel free, okay? Everyone will stay where you live at. The part of the main quest available during the beta. With the final update of the early access, after we implement other planned content and mechanics, then to... I don't know, this seems a little underwhelming. I was expecting we'd go to much more distant lands, explore distant places, not... You know, this is the same map. I'm starting to be very doubtful of the game. I mean, if this is the entire map, then I don't like it. I was expecting more mystical lands, more fantasy lands, more magical lands with many monsters, many civilizations and cultures. I think the Kickstarter promised us more civilizations, more stuff to visit. I mean, you're just going to get a bigger city than Menshire, which is a bigger city than Osbrook. So it's basically the same thing, except you have other buildings. I don't really see anything special about these three cities, so... I don't know, after so many years to add only this type of content, it seems like it's underwhelming to me. I think the game should have added more content, and of course I expect more enemy... I don't know, I expect more of everything. I guess we'll just have to see how the game will turn out, but... It doesn't look very promising, judging by... what they call a quest. So we can have a Rotten Willow Tavern. A reputation, I don't know. I guess it depends on how they do the rest of the game, but this is already feeling very lackluster. Anyway, see you next time. And don't forget, eat a lot of berries. Yum yum. Okay, bye.